Only Human Radio.
Here we go. First episode. Good Lord, Only Human Radio. Thank you so much for Dan's shot for letting us play on it. Andy, how exciting is this?
I know. It's going to be absolutely fantastic. I can't wait. Been looking forward to this.
Well, you know, I've hardly slept in weeks. I'm just thinking about this. It has been a very, very exciting time. Thank you so much to Circle 8 Radio for letting us do this show. And we're hoping not a disappointment to you. I'm here. I'm Jules. Who are you?
I'm Andy.
Oh, Andy's here.
But we're not alone, are we? We're not alone.
No, we're not.
We're not alone, Jules.
Because, and do you know why? Because we're in a massive studio. We've got a beautiful, luxurious recording studio here that Andy and I are separated, obviously, by glass screens to ensure that we're properly, fully isolated from each other. And then in the production area, we have Rob Dixon there pressing buttons. Dobre, if you press that big red button in front of you, you should be able to link straight through to us.
Evening, chaps.
Hey, Rob.
Look at that. Look at that. It's a good job we practiced all this. Actually, Andy's in his daughter's bedroom. I'm in my attic and Rob's in his front room. But you get the general idea. We probably should stop rambling on. I should stop rambling on. That would be the best thing, I think, all round. What's coming up tonight, Andy?
We're going to be throwing out some of the best of Only Human and Modulate tonight. So we're starting with a bang and we're just going to chuck out the best tunes we've got.
Starting with a bang, starting with a boom. I think you find it's a boom banger.
Yeah.
Because we've got Dr. Boom in the room. It's Dave Julian that we're kicking off with. I told you this was going to get a bit...
yes, mate. Dr. Boom.
Right, Dr. Boom. Brilliant. He's going to love that one.
Dr. Boom in the room. The Prince of Synthness himself, Dave Julian. So this is a new track from Dave, isn't it?
Yeah, Be Right Back. It's got vocal on it.
It's got everything.
I know he's got a vocoder, isn't he?
There's a vocoder on this. It's brilliant.
Is this actually Dave? Does it actually Dave doing the Be Right Back as well on there?
Yeah, it's Dave. Yeah,
he's done it all.
All right, tell you what. Let's stop rambling. Let's listen to that, and then we'll chat about it when we come back in. This is going to be amazing. Dave Julian. And what's it called?
Be Right Back.
Of course it is.
Don't
Dave Julian, always. I told you, he's the boom that shakes the room.
He is. He's getting better and better. I don't know where this is going to end.
Well, as you said the other week, Andy, it's, you know, Dave's not having to come from anywhere. He's just been there all along. The guy doesn't have a bad song. Every time he plays, everybody goes, "Well, the rest of you were great, but Dave Julian, well, he was fantastic."
Oh, he's. Yeah. I had a quick chat with. A quick chat with him in the week. And if we get to show two, he's going to come on and talk us through some of his gear.
Oh, that'd be good. Because is that in Andy's gear? What do we call it? Andy's gear corner. I think it was. We'll get an ident ready for that. For
it's
Andy's
a bit like
gear
compost
corner. Except without all that. I'd see. I need to use a swear word on the radio then.
So you can't do that.
You can't do that.
He's the king.
What's that, Dave Smith drum machine he's got?
He's got the Tempest, which is...
That's the one.
Bad, but I think on that track he's using the Alpha Bass by Joe Mox.
Right.
He is the Joe Mox.
Which is a serious, serious piece of drum synthesis.
But yeah, it was superb. Right, moving on, we've got our good friend Matt Garnett, who's helped us an awful lot with this as well. So we probably should explain a little bit about who's involved here. So Only Human is something you started, Andy.
Came up with the name.
Yeah, well, you know, it's enough. And then I know Rob's been involved right from the start, as has Matt Garnett as well. And this next song is from Matt Garnett, who's playing as Sword Swinging Robot. So Matt is a bit of a... I'm thoroughly embarrassed, actually, about my first meeting with Matt, because the first time I met Matt was the first Modulate night that Rob hosted. And then Matt came up afterwards and said, oh, you've inspired me to do a little bit more live performing. I haven't done it for a while. I said, oh, you should. Oh, no, really, you should. And I patronised massively until I heard him play and then realised how astonishingly good he is. And then I felt like the biggest idiot in the world.
Did you take him under your wing?
I tried to. And luckily, he realised that wing was a thoroughly scrawny chicken wing, which shouldn't be anywhere near a quality performer of his ilk.
It's interesting. Matt, I think, is what made me realise this, the whole kind of doing electronic music live could work, because someone like him coming out of the blue and, like you say, listening to him play live for the first time, it was like, whoa, right, so you're just the other side of Carnarvon somewhere doing this in your little studio and no one's hearing it. That is just mind-blowing. And I think he's played the majority of nights since, and he's utterly fantastic.
Should we have a listen to this and we'll talk about
it afterwards? Should we play his tune?
Why not? Go on. This is Sword Swinging Robot with Shake the Universe, I think it is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Don't shake the universe. Your time has come.
Shape the Universe, Sword Swinging Robot. There was a great acid line in there. Should I do the joke or not, Andy? Might as well.
No.
So it was a great acid line. Shape the Universe.
No.
Acid from Uranus. No?
No? Stop.
That's out already. It's done. Sorry about that. But anyway, sorry, I just must stop rambling. But it was good though, wasn't it? He is so good.
I like the Shake the Universe bit in the middle. You know, where he stretches that voice. It sounds absolutely ace. Dead good.
Slightly more in tune than that. But it's very, very good indeed. It really is. He's brilliant. And there was a kind of an Indian feel to parts of it as well.
But
I couldn't quite put my finger on what it was.
He did... I think Rihanna and his wife does belly dancing. So he's written music for... for the belly dancing group before. So a couple of his tracks have kind of got those Eastern Indian vibes in it, and I think it's kind of influenced by some of the kind of music he wrote for them.
So that was amazing from Sword Swinging Robot, Shape the Universe. Next up, we've got Andy. Just take us through this one a little bit. Is it Wasp and Dr. Skeim?
It's Waspberg and Dr. Skeim.
What a brilliant name.
Yeah, they're two individuals, but musician individuals, but quite often they will collaborate. We first came across them as a live entity when they played one of the Only Human night. Was it January? One of the Only Human nights in January. I'm losing track of time.
Were they the ones with the identical old school sampler drum machine?
RY30s.
RY30s, that's it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Brilliant.
Neither of them is anything. Sorry, Andy, go on. Speed rambling. Go on.
Yeah, no, they basically it's the first and maybe the last drum machine battle I've ever seen. They both rocked up with some Yamaha RY30s and battled 30 minutes. It was an absolute joy. I've seen Dr. Skyme play on his own, but I've never seen him play with somebody else. Wasp Berg.
Well, that's interesting because I wrote down when I listened to it, gritty and almost scary is what I wrote down. But in a really good way. And it just kind of developed through. And I was sitting there thinking, if I was watching a scary movie with this late at night on my own after four beers and a small whiskey, I would be very, very nervous because it really does build fantastically to this really gritty heart.
It creeps up from behind the sofa.
Cracky. What's that there? Oh, right. Should we have a listen?
Ooh. Yeah.
All right. Hey. brilliant. I love that. That was, as you say, super gritty.
Bit different, isn't it?
Yeah, really, really nice. Next up, we've got, is it Edgy?
Yeah, Edgy. Ian Edgington. Chester fella.
Only human stalwart, isn't he? He's been in the Facebook group since the beginning, Edgy, isn't he?
Yeah, he's been in the group since the start. He's quite prolific. He's always producing music. He shares it. He comes from an acid house background. He's a big fan of the TB303 sound and the 808s and things like that. So he played live with us at one of the Nexus nights, which is fantastic. But this is what he's just produced two new tunes. This one's called Plastic Love, one of his two new tunes. I don't know what the tempo is. It's quite a rolling tempo, but it's got his signature sort of acid house squiggles in there as well.
But it's got, I mean, it's a bit of a mixture of genres, really, and that work together really, really well. Is that you've got piano in there, you've got a choir in there, and as you say, you've got the acid line in there, and you've got lasers.
Yeah,
there's like laser sounds in there. It's got everything.
Yeah. But it's a great tune, and I've always really liked his productions as well. They're always very nicely produced, very nice, good to listen to. So, Edgy.
Let's have a listen.
Only Human Radio. I'm
well, that was lovely. And it wasn't too edgy. It was just really nice from Edgy,
if you
know what I mean. I like that an awful, awful lot.
And so that's the latest from Edgy. Brand new, that is.
So, we've got a proper treat coming up now. Blimey, it's surprising, really, that we can get people of this quality onto the show without having to pay them huge amounts of money, really. So it's, I'm a little bit taken aback, Andy, if I'm honest with you. It's you.
Who have we got? We've got Pegsy.
Yeah.
Pegsy in the house.
I'll tell you a story. See, it's not every day someone sends you an audition to play at Unite. Not that you really needed to, because it kind of modulate, and at that stage they'd have taken anyone with a synth. However, when someone sends you an audition that they've performed in a food market on a Friday night, whilst everyone's eating the pizza and the burgers, and he's banged out a 45-minute set of like techno music of just the highest quality that kind of at midday on a Saturday you're dancing around your kitchen to as you're making lunch. You're just thinking, well, again, it was another Matt Garnett moment. It was like, this is just utterly brilliant. Where's this guy come from? Of course he's going to play the nice.
Well, this is a belter, Andy. This is a proper belter, this one. I love this one. So is this the one... take us through it yourself. I'm not going to ramble on.
Well, I've had a bit of a musical excursion having met Rob. I love his modular stuff. So he's massively inspired me to do some modular stuff. But it really isn't in the vein of the what he was just describing. It's gone through stages, and I seem to be very much stuck in Doctor Who soundtrack mode. But anyway, cut long story short, I've decided to take a step back. I've tried to create something that's a little bit more listenable. I've got it's two electrons. It's the Digitone and Digitact. Purists will like my pronunciation, and it's a pop tune. Europop.
I wouldn't say Europop. I'd say Scandinavian disco, Andy. Wouldn't you?
Brilliant, if that's what you'd like to call it.
If I was going to pick a genre, I'd go Scandinavian disco. I can just see Sven standing in the corner there, smoking a small roll-up with his jeans rolled up, just like two turns up at the bottom. Sleeves rolled up, light jacket. I like this.
Just need some Erlandoy on vocals, and then you've kind of nailed the Scandi
pop. I do like Todd Terrier and Lindstrom and guys like that. So it's a bit of an homage to those ace producers. But let's
have a listen, Andy. I think everybody's going to thoroughly enjoy this. Roll your sleeves up slightly. Take a couple of turnips up. Roll a small cigarette. Enjoy the CD player.
Thank you.
Only Human Radio.
Good Lord. Well, how do you top that? Eh? Andy
Might
Pex?
As well stop now.
I don't know, but he made me want to go get a pullover and drape it casually around my neck.
And have some meatballs.
What, and go... No.
That was brilliant, Andy. It really was fantastic. And it's great to be back in Scandinavia again. It's lovely. Next up, we've got Christopher Kay, who is Malleus.
Yeah.
Malleus? Would you say, yeah. Andy?
Malleus.
And you said he's been part of the community for a while as well, hasn't he?
He has, yeah. He's quite a handy photographer. He's taken some shots of Only Human event. What we're going to play tonight is his contribution to the Only Human 2 compilation.
Well, I remember this one because I can remember talking to you about this one before, and this is the one I do use this phrase a lot. I should probably find a second phrase, which is an ethereal soundscape, but it has got a really, it starts like a bit of an anthem, and then it develops into this like ethereal soundscape, and it's almost like a movie soundtrack that you're listening to.
I could hear. I'm quite a fan of Ennio Morricone, his spaghetti stuff, and I can hear shades. I'm not saying it sounds like Ennio Morricone, but I can hear little shades, little motifs in there that just remind me, like key changes and the way it flows. But it is soundtrack. I made some notes as well. I wrote soundtrack as well.
Well, that's great. Well, what we should do is do like a bingo next time. So we'll all write down a series of phrases and then we'll see who wrote down Sidetrack. I'll do my Bruce Forsyth impression throughout the whole thing. Or did he do well? Etc.
I think this is one of the highlights of the Only Human 2 compilation. I think it's really great. Really good.
I'd agree with you, absolutely. It's just a beautiful developing piece as well as it moves on. And it's just nice one to sit back and relax and listen to and just listen to it evolve.
Well, I contacted him on the run-up to this just to double-check we were okay to use his tune and what have you. And he's very humble about it. And he said that he creates a lot of it on... created on a computer, DAW, and he was very humble, saying, "Oh, you know, I can't really play, and so I use a DAW and everything." But I think that's a bit of a misconception, really, because some of the stuff I've heard created on computers is absolutely magical stuff. So I think he should be prouder of it. You know, I think it's ace.
I agree with you 100%, Andy. I mean, it doesn't matter. We've said this about when we've been doing the Modulate TV, when people are using single box pieces and saying it isn't about the piece of equipment you're using, it's about the talent using the piece of equipment. And it doesn't matter whether you're using a piece of hardware, using a piece of software, it doesn't matter what you're using. If the piece of music you produce out at the end of that is pleasurable to you and is pleasurable, well, most importantly to you, but if it's also pleasurable to other people, that's a bonus.
Yeah.
But it doesn't matter what you use, as long as that piece of music is nice at the end of it and you're happy with it. Who cares what you produce?
It doesn't matter what controller you use, whatever you're using. It's all open. You know, if you're making good music, then doesn't matter. Doesn't matter how you've created it. But I think this is great.
Malleus, Christopher K. Crikey, that was...
It's called Channels. I like the name as well. It's a good name.
Yeah, well, actually, sometimes the name doesn't suit the song, but that name did suit the song.
Yeah, yeah.
It was beautiful. Really, really beautiful. Really enjoyed that. Oh, dear. Very sorry. It's
me. Is it you now?
It is.
It's a good tune, this.
It's only good because Matt Garnett had a fiddle about with it and made it significantly better.
Is this on the Only Human 2 compilation as well?
It is indeed, yeah. Yeah. It is. And I thought I'd experiment a little bit with a different BPM.
What is it? It's quite low, isn't it?
I think it's 108 from memory. But also just try and change things around a little bit, because normally I try and do fast dance music, which doesn't work, and then end up slightly disappointed in it. But this one, I thought I'd go a little bit slower and be slightly less disappointed, and I was correcting my assumption. So it's actually... It's not too bad.
It's an interesting point, you know, that you're saying, like, someone else improving it. I think quite often a lot of us will try and perfect a track ourselves, but you think most electronic music, you think Chemical Brothers, Left Field, Underworld, do you mean they're a partnership for a reason, and different people bring different strengths. I think there's nothing wrong, I don't think, in having someone else listen to what you've done and add some production here and there to kind of bring something else to the track. Something I'd certainly like to do more of, because I think different if you're producing a track live, but if you have got the stems for it, and sometimes someone else can just bring something that you've not heard yourself, and it can totally make a track. Certainly nothing to be ashamed of, I think.
Well, this is why you have producers as well.
Yeah.
And why you have people who do mastering and all the rest of it. That's, you know, it's great that somebody can produce that initial piece of music, but somebody else can then take those little bits and just tweak and change and amend and slightly retime and whatever, and then turn it into something significantly better than it was in the first place. Which is exactly
that's the thing about electronic music, though, isn't it? It's quite demanding in terms of the amount of information that or the amount of skills that you need to have, really, because you need to be a musician, you need to be a technician, an engineer, a producer, to get from A to B. It's quite a journey, really.
Yeah,
and an entire band as well. You got to come with the drums, the bass line, and the lead, which to me, so it's I think we're all our own worst critics at times. And
well, and on that, let's get it over and done with. Right, here we go. Thank you.
Only Human Radio.
Oof, well, wake up, everybody. Are we still there? Is anybody here?
Yeah, it's good, that is. I like that.
Oh, great. Thanks, mate. Cheers, mate. Great stuff. that was me, sadly. Right, and we're moving on to another one of our trio tonight. Robbo.
Hello.
We've got a little number you kicked out whilst you were kicked out of your house, not by your wife, but just by your builders.
Yeah, little lockdown tune. I think this was in temporary accommodation number 2, which was, I have to say, a most gorgeous place to be living out 2 weeks of the lockdown in the Nantyglyn Valley in Colwyn Bay, in Foxhill House. We're in the basement, and whilst the world was falling apart and I was trying to work out how to do my day job in a house with two kids who were at school, when everyone had gone to bed, I'd get the modular case out and sit there for a couple of hours in the evening and put the world to rights in my head, which actually proved to be quite a productive time, really, strangely enough. So, yeah, and this tune is one of those that came out of that period of those 2 weeks at Foxhill.
I like all your stuff, obviously. See, when if I say like I really like this one, it makes it sound like I don't like this. I obviously like them all, but this one, to me, just has a more, what's the word I'm trying to look for here? So it has a more rounded feel to it as a tune for me. So just the sort of music I would normally choose to listen to. So as an electronic music piece, is more like dance music. This is more in style with that rather than being a more diverse piece, which is more experimental.
Yeah.
So this is less, I probably should start with that with saying this is less experimental and more perhaps not mainstream, but do you know what I'm trying to squeeze? Yeah.
I'll tell you what it does do. It's
interesting.
I'm
sure Andy will find this with the modular, that the machines kind of more often lead you to the outcome than the other way around. I think the nature of having a set of modules and the unpredictability of how they're going to interact with each other, sometimes it sounds great, other times it just sounds like something you wouldn't inflict on your worst enemy. And the trick is, when it sounds great during press record and try and capture 5 or so minutes of something that sounded good to you. It doesn't always work, but yeah, when you capture those moments where everything has just come together, it's fabulous. Can never be repeated, of course, but there we go. That's the perils of doing it on modular as well. They're all just one-off pieces.
I love that, though. I love the idea of that. I think that's a really great way of making music.
No, I agree. I think surprised. If someone had told me that, I always wanted to play music live and never quite worked how. If you told me years ago I'd do it on a completely unpredictable modular synth where you kind of stand up and don't actually know what the first sound that's going to come out is exactly going to sound like, but you've somehow got to stand there for half an hour and, I mean, I guess entertain is a strong word, but not leave people running out of the room screaming down there.
I remember you telling me once that that you were staring at a particular module for about 15 minutes waiting for it to do something, and that was in the middle of a live performance.
Yeah, well, it was more waiting for it to stop doing something. It was a noise.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, it was a noise, and I couldn't identify which module it was coming from, and it was very persistent and very annoying to me. And you kind of find yourself being convinced that the audience are as fixated on this particular noise as you. And of course they're not. They're having a chat and having a beer and probably haven't even noticed. But yeah, it's a very uncomfortable experience when you stood up there and you're trying to problem solve on the spot. And, and you're improvising as well. So you can't stop. There's nothing to fall back on. You've just got to kind of go with it and hope for the best.
What's this one called? Yeah.
Fox Hill 3.
Let's have a listen to Fox Hill 3. We'll be right back.
Only Human Radio.
Fox Hill 3. If that is that good, I want to listen to Fox Hill 1, 2 and 0.5.
The first I ever played Modular Live, some guy came up to me and it was oscilloscope. And the great thing about oscilloscope is you can play absolutely anything and it's the most wonderfully receptive audience. Slightly strange thing is there's a bit of Q&A at the end of it where people can ask you questions about what you've just done. And I remember doing something, and this guy congratulated me, and I think it was on a 3-7 polyrhythm or something. Not only did I have no idea what a polyrhythm was at that point and had to go look it up afterwards, but it was like the thought that I was intentionally able to produce any kind of rhythm at that point was stretching things somewhat. But there we go.
Well, I enjoyed it. You can see Andy enjoyed it.
Love it. I've been listening to a lot of Rob's music recently, so I'm in there. I'm in the zone.
Was he lending you some CDs? What?
No. He's I've got some of his tunes on the Google Drive, and we're looking at creating an album for him. I'm just sort of shuffling things around and putting them in the right order. Well, I think it's the right order, but I have spent quite a bit of time with Rob's recent music, and it's really very rewarding, I have to say. Really good stuff.
Well, is that the Fox Hill
album? There's Fox Hill 1, Fox Hill 2, Fox Hill 3, the stuff that you will have heard on the recent Modulate. There's some stuff that you might not have heard, so it's just a waiting game to get it out there, but it's almost there.
When's that likely to be coming out?
I don't know. Soon.
Who knows?
Soon. Oh, you're just building the excitement up there, aren't you? Well, the next, as you brought the mood down, the next sad thing to announce is this is the last song, So which I can't believe. But what a belter to end on. Hans Delbruck.
Hans Delbruck. Brook. I'm not sure. I don't know.
Yeah, I think I'm over it. I went over
it's to Harry Walker anyway.
It's Harry, indeed.
This is just, we were talking before, weren't we, saying, was that Gene Wilder in there? And there is, there's a young Frankenstein Gene Wilder sample in there as well, which goes in it, which you don't really...
Isn't Hans Delbruck a character in Young Frankenstein?
Ah,
I don't know.
Do you know what? I think you're right.
I don't know if that's right or not.
I think he said he took his name from the film that he sampled the vocals for this track from, I think, didn't he? So,
well, in that case, that's Young Frankenstein, so it must be. There's two amazing acid lines throughout this as well, which are just fantastic. I just wish I had some of the talent to be able to do this. And you mentioned as well, this is actually an old piece, Andy, isn't it?
It's 20 years old. But this is like I don't know whether you would call it a remix or how you would describe it.
I think.
Yeah, a rework.
It's reworked. Yeah, reworked it, isn't he?
Yeah, so it's the tune's called Reanimated, but I think that doesn't reference him reworking it. It was always called Reanimated, but it's called Reanimated 2020. The thing, the production on values on this is phenomenal. Yeah. It's just so pro skills production. It's ace. Really, really good.
It is, and there's a really deep pumping bass line that goes throughout this as well, which is just about heart thumping. And you said this was actually pressed to vinyl as well.
Well, yes. Harry sent me a message to say that the original of this sold up 500 copies, 500 vinyl copies back in the day. So it has pedigree. But this is the 2020 version of Reanimated.
And as we were saying before, if you'd sold 500 vinyl copies in this day and age, you'd be number four in the charts.
Yeah, that's right.
That'd be quite a thing. So I tell you what, let's have a listen. Let's have a listen. Hans Delbruck, Harry Walker. This is just an awesome song to end off with. Dark techno, indeed.
Became capable of bestowing animation
That was dark techno. It has got that real feel to it, and then that Gene Wilder and all the rest of it. So Hans Delbrück, that was brilliant, fantastic. Very much Harry Walker. Well, that's hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, whatever it was, has gone so beautifully quickly for me, certainly. It's probably been dragging for everybody else listening for out there. But hopefully there's been some stuff that everybody's enjoyed, and I'm sure you have done, and hopefully we'll be asked back to do a second show. You never know your luck. Andy, can we run through what we've had tonight?
Sure.
We've had some astonishing talent on this evening.
We've had Dave Julian, Be Right Back. Prince of Synthness.
The Prince of Synth.
Sword Swinging Robot, Shake the Universe. We've got Wasp and Dr. Skym, who were Far From Home. We've got Edgy, Plastic Love. We've got myself, Latimeria, that's a big fish. Save you looking it up.
Oh, yeah. Is it?
Malleus, Channels.
Oh, well, Robs, what's Malleus then?
He's not
I think
listening.
There's a bone in the inner ear that's shaped like a hammer.
He just knows any Latin word at all. Astonishing. Absolutely. Sorry, Andy, go on. Yeah.
Then we had Your Good Self, Citizen Fly, with Caution.
Yeah.
A highlight of the OH2 compilation. We've got Rob, Etch-A-Sketch with Fox Hill 3, and we finished up with Hans Delbruck, Reanimated 2020.
Well, what an amazing lineup. I'm sad this is over. Can we do this again soon?
Yeah,
maybe?
Let's do it again. But we'll get to
that'd be nice.
We're gonna do some interviews, Gear Corner or Geek's Gear or something like that.
Andy's Geek Gear Corner.
Yeah.
I think that's what it's gonna be. Well, it's been a great fun. Thoroughly enjoyable afternoon, evening. The whole day's just been a mould into one. Hopefully we'll see you all again soon. Circle 8 Radio, thank you so much for asking us to do this. We've enjoyed it thoroughly. I'm Jules.
I'm Andy.
I'm Rob.
And Andy's going to do, as usual, the big goodbye.
See ya. Take care. Be good to each other.
See you again soon. Bye-bye.
Only Human Radio.